Apple Notes is one of the largest note-taking applications in the productivity market, but it really goes unnoticed because it's already installed on iOS and Mac devices on millions, maybe even billions of people's devices around the world. Today, we're going to give you a comprehensive guide to understanding Apple Notes and taking advantage of it. I'm not going to give you some of the basics. I'm going to dive into a few of the more intermediate tips and tricks to really mastering Apple Notes in today's video. And hopefully you can walk away a little bit more of an Apple Notes maestro from this video. Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. My name is Francesco. I'm very excited to dive into Apple Notes. It is very much the meme. If you are at the front end or the back end, Apple Notes is one of those experiences that if you really get involved in it, it can be quite an advanced note-taking application. And it really does remind me of that meme, because when I was working at a company many years ago, the guy who ran it, the CEO, was just using Apple Notes and he was pretty happy. And I was there like with this advanced Evernote setup, and it really is a depiction of the meme that I regularly post on social media. So today I've broken it into a few sections, but before we begin, today's video is sponsored by Toolfinder. You can find it linked below. Toolfinder is something we've created to help you find the best productivity tools. You can find it linked in the description, as well as our brand new newsletter for diving into the latest productivity tools on the market. So let's start with organization. And this is something that Apple Notes does okay. It's not something that's going to revolutionize your setup, but the main feature that really goes unhidden or hidden is something called smart folders. And it's a way for you to set up folders inside your Apple Notes that meet a certain criteria. And that could be anything, amazingly, from pinned posts or pinned notes in a certain folders or across folders, or maybe even notes that are created within a certain date. And it can also be stuff like tags, things that you add to your notes to give them more context. But this means that you can span notes that go not just between one folder, but many folders inside of it. Now, if you're doing this on Mac, it's gonna look a little bit different. However, on iPad, it looks probably the most in-depth or the most best demonstration of how it fully works. Inside of this smart folder area, you can set up filters for not just all, but any or and additional ones, which make it the perfect place to really set up a combination of filters that might suit your new smart folder. This is great not only for the tags, not only for the notes, but you can also filter through a wide variety of different types of notes, like notes that have handwriting in it, notes that are created with quick notes, and even things like locked notes, allowing you to see all of your most private notes across all of the folders that you may have created inside of Apple Notes. Now, if you're somebody that doesn't know, you can go ahead and create folders and set them up with your iCloud sync account, which means that if you have multiple Apple devices, they will sync across the board. This is great for keeping in touch with one note that might be updated with another note that is synchronized in real time. So I fully recommend checking out this feature if you're looking to go a little bit deeper when it comes to organization and setup when starting off with Apple Notes. Okay, so when it comes to creating your notes inside of Apple Notes, there are two elements that really go unnoticed when taking advantage of that. And that's the toolbar area, which you can actually edit and customize much further inside of all versions of Apple Notes, which means you can choose what goes on that toolbar at the top. But what's really nice is you can create tables here. Now, tables are very basic in the extent that they are nothing like Notion databases, but they provide you with a great way for you to get started adding information. Now, for example, if you wanted to move stuff around, you can move around columns, add columns and rows, and really change the information inside of it, like make it bold, italic, or even add more formatting if you did want to. But tables are great, and one of my favorite uses is for games like we do Rummy and things like that, tallying scores and shorter based stuff like that. But it can also go much further, like creating a pros and cons list for a house you might be buying, and you could be sharing that with your partner, which I'll talk to a little bit later on in this video. Something else you can add inside of your note in Apple Notes is tasks. And funnily enough, they aren't connected with Apple Reminders just yet, but you can create these small checklists which are perfect for managing a grocery list or keeping an eye on what project items and tasks you have inside of your workload. But what's really nice is you can actually search in the search bar for anything that is checklist based, which is great for finding it for later. You can't go and add due dates and information like that, but it is handy when you're creating a smart folder. You can create it with checklist in mind, making sure that you keep all of your checklists in one folder organized so you can find all of the tasks that are relevant. But in general, checklists can be used throughout a note, anywhere throughout the note, which makes it perfect for being able to embed with other such media like note-taking or even handwriting. So Apple Notes is really underrated for its capture and find abilities. Search, as I just mentioned, is quite powerful. You can actually search anything that is handwriting based, which makes using the Apple Pencil much more effective on the iPad and even iPhone. If you don't use your, maybe just use your fingers, then it actually allows you to capture that quite easily, but also make sure you can find those really fast. Another element of Apple Notes that people don't really check out is the ability to capture stuff really fast using Force Touch. This is a feature that is available on most iPhones now, but if you push down on the Apple Notes app, you can quickly take a note and even take advantage of scanning a document from here as well. And scanning of documents is something that comes in a really high quality, almost or on par to the likes of Evernote scanning abilities. And it makes it great for being able to send documents to other people just from the Apple Notes application. And it will save it in line, which means you can give it a title and even reference it for later, which makes it perfect for being able to grab stuff really quickly without downloading a third-party application. Another quick ability is on any of your devices, if you swipe to the bottom right-hand corner, you can take a quick note, which is a great way to save a bit of time, especially if you're on Mac. And this is a really handy function and gets saved into your quick notes area, which is a separate area of Apple Notes, which appears at the top, below or above shared. And it makes it great for being able to quickly access that if you've got multiple of them and you haven't yet organized that into a folder, which really incites the likes of GTD, Getting Things Done, a book by David Allen. So next up is collaboration. And to be honest, I never really thought of Apple Notes as a good collaboration tool. The application itself is a really simple tool in nature, but I never really thought about it until recently when creating weekly plans with me and my wife that it really clicked and actually made it quite an effective way to do that together. Now, let's be fair, trying to get my wife on something like Evernote or Mem probably would be much more difficult. So I thought maybe I could use the collaborative function inside of Apple Notes. And recently we've created a week plan, which is a set of dates, of activities we're doing and a set of meals with a table and outlining what meals I'm having each night, as well as any other information. This is really becoming our base, which we change every single week. And now I can see updates that she posts and she can see updates that I post. This is really simple to set up. And all you do is you actually share the note via iMessage. The other person will accept the collaboration. And from here, you can modify the note in detail, which is great. But it's nice as well because it's not, say, in real time. So you can't see each other's cursors, but you can see each other's updates. And if you swipe right on the note itself, you can actually see highlights that the other person has made in a bit more detail. Now, I can also share this with more people, meaning I don't have to limit it just to one person. I could share this with roommates, and you can still use the checklist functionality as well as all of the rest of the functionality you get inside of your Apple Notes account, which makes it a great base for organizing a checklist of roommate stuff to do, like clearing the house, organizing chores, etc., etc. So this application is great as well for capturing images inside of here, which means you can bring together ideas, thoughts, and processes all in one base. On iPad and iPhone, the settings in Apple Notes are pretty good. You can go into quite a high level of detail when it comes to organizing the structure and layout of your folders, and also what note appears, as well as the titles and details like that. Now, there's also great ways on Mac to be able to lock your notes. You can set a password or configure it to have Touch ID, which makes all of your notes much more secure. And as I was mentioning earlier, you can actually create a smart folder based on all of your locked notes, which is a perfect place maybe for a journal or details like that. although Apple does have a journal application coming up. Now, one of the questions I'm sure I'll get in this video is, what's the difference between Apple Freeform and Apple Notes? Well, they're very similar in a lot of ways. You can collaborate in real time on them, but Freeform goes in much more detail with the ability to add post-it notes and much more detail around each note when it comes to collaboration, which means you can draw shapes and modify information in real time, seeing each other's cursors and interactions. And you can even do stuff like join a FaceTime together, which means you can see each other in real time on iPad and Mac devices. But it also works great asynchronously for planning and organizing ideas and thoughts with family, friends, and maybe business colleagues, but as long as they've got your Apple ID and they're signed into the right Freeform account. So the differences are pretty clear. Freeform, much better for collaboration, and the likes of Apple Notes, much better for much lighter forms of collaboration. Freeform is much more like Miro, whereas Apple Notes is much more like Obsidian. Not quite, but you get what I mean. A note-taking application versus a whiteboard application. Now, iOS 17 is introducing some pretty decent abilities like note PDFs and also note linking, which means you can create bidirectional links between certain notes that you have inside of your account. Something small, and it might tailor towards the PKM, personal knowledge management market, but something that probably the average Apple Notes user will enjoy, but not rely on entirely. There's a great video by Paperless X which overviews all of the iOS 17 updates that are expected in September or October of 2023, which will give you a great outline of how Apple Notes is going to evolve. But one of the biggest things is the collaborative PDFs, allowing you and your team, or maybe even you and you as a student, to be able to collaborate on a PDF in real time. And that includes the annotation abilities as well. This is similar to Freeform in a way, but really condensed into Apple Notes, whereas I would say Freeform is much better for collaborative whiteboard function like Miro and be able to bring ideas together, whereas this is much better for annotating and revising information that you've already got. So this was a little bit more about Apple Notes, and I tried to go from a different angle with this application or this overview to give you a better idea of how Apple Notes works and to give you a better idea of how to take it a little bit further if you're using it right now. So if you're interested in Toolfinder, you can find it linked below. It will help you find a productivity tool, and it's our base for that. So if you're interested in checking that out, if you're interested in the newsletter, and of course, if you're interested in subscribing here on Keep Productive, we would love to have you. So do make sure to check all of those out before leaving this video. But if you are interested in some of our other videos here on the channel, you can jump over to our channel to subscribe, but also find the recommended videos after this and enjoy them to continue learning about more productivity and systems as well. Thank you very much, everyone, and I'll see you all in a future video, I'm sure. Cheerio.